Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Here's an update what's going on at Yellowstone. I'm sorry, the end of the world is not today. There was an earthquake, actually two, here on this page. I downloaded and updated my different monitors that I'm pulling in. Down here we have Panther. Alright, and in the middle we have the Promontory. And at the top is West Thumb. Two of the monitors there on the thumbnails have been showing a lot of activity, a lot of lines in red. Let me pull this from the Mammoth Vault. Yeah, everyone's freaking out about this. Here we have the monitor for the borehole. This is borehole at the vault 945. And Soda Butte. Now if you look at this, and I've talked about how all the ones marked in red are earthquakes. That is a message sent to the seismologist to investigate. But these are not earthquakes. Here at the borehole, you don't see anything marked in red. We do have a thickening of the line, magma coming into the system. And what looks to be a lot of strange harmonic tremors, strange activity. Going back to the Mammoth Vault, now you can see earthquakes underneath all this stuff of red. Earthquake there, yeah, blobs of magma coming in, but all this is not what it seems to be. USGS, or one of the other many companies that maintain and keep an eye on what's going on at Yellowstone, is doing testing, or the equipment is failing. How did I figure that out? Okay, here at Panther, I'm going to extract a small portion of this. First thing I noticed is the line of amplitudes all the way up here at 4,000 amplitudes. All equipment should be set at no higher than 250. I'm going to bring the horizontal down so we can see it better. And I'm going to zoom into the signature. And that's what you got, the little sawtooth. Yeah, this equipment has failed, stopped working, or they're doing testing. I'll pull the same section from the Promontory and show you this. Okay, see the amplitudes? Yeah, big difference. Alright, we'll bring this horizontal down. There we go. Oh, probably about 25. And we'll bring it over to look at what's going on. Harmonic tremors or volcanic tremors. Yeah, we know that this area has a crack at the bottom of the lake and magma intrusion of rhyolites trying to come up. I'll pull the same section from West Thumb. And here you can see the amplitudes and then the earthquakes. Let me bring this down. We got an earthquake in there. But in general, see how it's set? Many years ago, when I first started following the earthquake activity at Yellowstone, there was a site that was available, and it showed the voltage of the different monitors. That site is no longer active, no longer available to the public. There's many reasons why they keep the amplitude turned down. One, so you can actually see the earthquakes. I found a paper on USGS about how they're supposed to set up these monitors. They're all digital now. They went digital many years ago. And it goes into testing. I'm going to show you routine operational tests that they do. The ANSS will perform various routine on-site and laboratory operational tests to verify the continuing performance of the DAAs and supporting system it operates. These routine operational tests may include automatic self-testing by the DAS, manual or automated sensor tests, manual or automatic voltage tests, or other field tests by maintenance personnel. It is recommended that two or more test specimens be selected at random from a batch of eight or more final manufactured copies of final versions of the proposed sensor DAU or DAS. So either they're doing testing on two different sites, or they have two different sites that the equipment has failed, stopped working. The Mammoth Vault is picking up a lot of outside noise. Let me go to this signature. Yeah, this is a signature that you would have if you had a spectrogram for outdoors or birds and traffic and things like that. Here we have the promontory. See the difference? And then we'll go to West Thumb right there. Reason I got the same time for each of them so you can see how they're working. I've talked about earthquake signatures in the past. How we know when an earthquake occurs, if it's a landslide or rock slide, the signature comes from the top and moves down. See that? This is the borehole, and we're picking up outside noise on this monitor. It comes from the top going down. Here we have the same time for the promontory and for West Thumb. 2343 at the promontory, we had one earthquake marked in red. That's it right there. And we have the same time over here at the borehole for the vault, Mammoth Hot Springs, and over here. See the difference in signatures? And I'll show you the spectrograms. See where the earthquake came up? Yeah, and see how this one is showing mostly the noise coming from the top going down? Because this monitor is not working correctly, you cannot see the earthquakes, you cannot see how deep the magma is at the line of melt right there on the promontory. Here we have West Thumb, and this is the vault, the borehole. Yeah, you can't really tell. All you see is maybe some hot pockets, but let's go to the signature. Yeah, you can't really see what is going on because this equipment is not working correctly. You can see the time here at 11:11. This one's like 11:10. We'll go over a little bit. Let's see, 11:11 and 30 seconds right there. And let's fix this one. Yeah, you would assume that this would be harmonic tremors or drum beats as the magma going into the system. It could be. You don't know because this equipment has failed. It's not working. Did someone deliberately change the settings? Did someone bump it? Or has it failed? I don't know. Let me bring this down so you can see it. Oop. Yeah. Like I said, the settings are not right. I don't know if it's on purpose. I think someone would be more worried about losing their job than pulling a prank. But one, the equipment is not set at the right microvolts. Let me go back a little bit farther. Here it's almost all the way up to 6,000. 6,000. Let me pull it down. There we go. And we'll zoom into the signature. Yeah, this equipment is not set at the right microvolts. I don't know why. You have to ask them, and of course they wouldn't give you an honest answer. But if someone did not have the ability to pull this data and to notice what the amplitude was set at, what the microvolts were set at, you could be very easily confused, persuaded that something else is going on than what really is. This earthquake here, and let me go back ahead another 4 hours. The other one was probably at Sawtooth right there. And I say that because of the P wave, the first wave of the earthquake. Let me change the vertical on here. And then I'll change so we can zoom in on it. Yeah, this was at Sawtooth. I'll show you that. Hold on. Right there, and let me pull this over. 2331 at magnitude 1.3. That, of course, is the only earthquake that they are reporting for the Yellowstone area. Let me zoom out a little bit. 22 kilometers east of Lima, Montana. And then using Google Earth, let's zoom out to see exactly where this earthquake occurred. Over here on the right, we have Hedgen Lake. And the location of the 1959 earthquake, that was a magnitude 7.3. Now, in the area of the Mammoth Fault, there is a lot of newly discovered small volcano cones and lava flows that they only recently discovered. I did a video about that maybe 3 years ago, and they only discovered them when they were surveying for a new road. There's cliffs of obsidian glass from lava flows. Let me zoom in on this a little bit, and you can see this area and all the activity from past eruptions. Yeah, the lava flows. See, though, these are all past lava flows. Let me bring it back out. Here's one of the small volcano cones. See that? See, as I zoom in, how it becomes 3D, and you can see the magma, or the lava, I should say. Yeah, that's now still visible there. Indian Creek is another area, not far from there. Let me bring it back out. There's a volcano cone in Indian Creek. It's a campground. Yeah, it's an area of a lot of past lava flows. So we'll take another view of Old Faithful and the Norris Geyser Basin. Yeah, look at all the dead trees back up over here and over there. Sometimes I like to watch and see if there's any landslides on the cliffs behind from earthquakes. But that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Like I said, it is recharging for another eruption, but it's not erupting today. Yeah, look at all those. Well, if you bring it over for you so you can see the dead trees. See them? Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.